बर्थडे को आज ही वहां बोला है
रियल लाइव है
ना के
ना के गुड इवनिंग एंड वेलकम एवरीबॉडी टू दिस फर्स्ट ऑर्थो टीवी बेसिक पेल्विक एसिड डेवलपमेंट सीरीज एंड वी हैव टुडे विद अस डॉक्टर अतुल पाटिल हु इज द कन्वीनर ऑफ द सीरीज एंड डॉक्टर श्रीनिवास खाशा हु इज द गेस्ट फैकल्टी टुडे एंड without wasting time I'll hand it over to Dr. Srinivas for his presentation. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Ashok. So I must thank Dr. Ashok Shyam and Dr. Atul Patil for involving me in this particular session on pelvic-vascular trauma. I'm just going to start by sharing my screen. Yeah. So classification of acetabular fractures is something like Padma view. Unless you into pelvic acetabular surgery, unless you know the classification, you can't attempt to do any surgery, or you can't even understand what's happening inside the pelvis or acetabulum. So this is the main crucial step in anybody's learning. Way when somebody wants to take up this pelvic acetabular surgery and learn the basics of it. So as all of us know, we have got iliopubic and ischial components in the pelvic innominate bone. So if you see this particular picture, towards left side is ilioischial component and towards right side is iliopubic component. These are known as, at the same time, anterior and posterior columns of the acetabulum. So the anterior column is also known as iliopubic component. In this, you have got superior pubic ramus, anterior part of the acetabulum, supraacetabular area of anterior part, anterior one third of the iliac wing. At the same time, in the posterior column, you got ilioischial component, where you got ischial ischium and part of the ilium and up to sciatic notch and posterior part of the acetabulum. So Litornell and Judet have classified the acetabular fractures into something like posterior wall, posterior column, anterior wall, anterior column, and transverse fracture was also included into the elementary fracture. Whereas associated fractures are relatively complex in this posterior column with posterior wall, anterior column with posterior hemitransverse, transverse with posterior wall, T-shaped fractures, and both column fractures. So for our convenience, all these things can be kept, especially both column fracture, T-shaped fracture, and transverse with posterior column and transverse fracture can be kept as a complex variety for our classification, which I am going to show you in next few slides. So when you have the posterior wall fracture, which is elementary fracture, it can be seen something like this in a three-dimensional picture. I'll show you a radiographic representation of the same in the coming slides. Whereas posterior column is something like a when you have the pillar which is involved, that is, that becomes a posterior column. So it is something like a construction place where you have got, where you have the pillars built first, followed by the walls. The pillar is more important. Similarly, in the acetabulum, the column is the base onto which you got the wall. So if you see this particular thing, you got posterior column in this particular picture, which has got involved, and which has to be restored on a priority basis when compared to a wall, when both are associated, and when there is posterior column with posterior wall associated, which I am going to show you in few slides. And anterior wall, this is the anterior wall fracture. Anterior column, where you have got an extension of anterior iliopectineal line and involvement of the anterior third of the iliac wing or iliac crest. And transverse fracture, where both the columns are broken, but part of the acetabulum will be intact with the sciatic buttress or the iliac wing. Part of the acetabulum is always intact with the axial skeleton. Well, that is gone, it becomes a associated fracture, that is known as both column fracture. So these are associated varieties, where posterior column and posterior wall, which I was telling. So column is something like a pillar onto which you have got a wall. In this thing, you have got posterior column as well as wall of the acetabular fracture. As well, in this picture, you have got anterior column and posterior hemitransverse fracture. So transverse with posterior wall fracture. So as I told you, both columns are broken, but it is not a both column fracture, as part of the acetabulum is in continuation with the axial skeleton. Whereas T-shaped fracture, where you got obturator ring involvement along with the transverse fracture. And both column fracture, where the sciatic buttress the acetabulum has got disconnected with the axial skeleton, as you see in this particular picture. I am not sure whether you are able to get the pointer. Yeah. So these are the very important views in this. The lines which I am going to tell you are very important to take to classify any of the fractures. So the first and foremost important line is iliopectineal line, which usually represents the anterior column. Ilioischial line, which represents the posterior column. I'll show you these are pictures. That is iliopectineal line. The red line, which you can see, is an iliopectineal line, which represents involvement of the anterior column. The ilioischial line represents posterior column. And another important thing is integrity of this obturator ring, which has some important role in classifying all the acetabular fractures. If it represents the integrity of ilioischial and iliopubic components. So, and the most important views, you've got anteroposterior view, which I have shown, and you have got a Judet view. Profile. So where you have got a tilt onto the opposite side of around 45 degrees. And you can see anterior column represented by iliopectineal line in this, and posterior wall is clearly seen in this particular view. So iliopectineal line and posterior wall or lip is clearly seen. And wherever you have a fracture of posterior lip, this view can easily pick up posterior wall fracture. Similarly, iliac oblique view, where you've got the iliac wing in full profile, and you can see the posterior column, which is represented here. You can see the line. So posterior column integrity can easily be assessed with the iliac oblique view, wherein the patient is tilted towards the side of the interest of around 45 degrees again. So it also gives an idea of anterior lip. So what is transverse fracture and what is both column fracture, we have to know. They divide the hemipelvis into two parts through some portion of the acetabulum. Therefore, both columns are divided, but part of the acetabulum is in continuation with the axial skeleton or a sciatic buttress. Where if no part of the acetabulum is in continuation with the sciatic buttress, it becomes a floating acetabulum, or known as bicolumnar fracture. Even here you've got both columns involved, but the thing is no part of the acetabulum is in continuity with the axial skeleton. So this particular algorithm is taught to me by Professor Ganslin. And this particular, although it looks very complex, it's very, very simple, wherein you have got three lines: iliopectineal line, ilioischial line, and fracture of the inferior pubic ramus or a obturator ring involvement. If you have these three things known in a AP pelvis X-ray itself, you can all you can diagnose almost all fractures of the acetabulum. So let us see how it is possible. So you've got three lines and 10 types of acetabular fractures: the posterior wall, posterior column, anterior wall, anterior column, transverse fracture, posterior column with posterior wall, transverse with posterior wall, T-shaped fracture, anterior column, posterior hemitransverse fracture, and both column fracture. For our convenience, we'll keep these last three fractures as complex varieties: T-shaped, anterior column with posterior hemitransverse, and both column fractures, so that it makes our classification very easy to understand and usable by you immediately after this lecture. So the first thing is iliopectineal line. So which I have already shown, if that is intact, what it means is you've got involvement of anterior volum, anterior column, transverse with posterior wall, T-shaped, anterior column with posterior hemitransverse, and both column. That means anterior wall is not involved whenever you have got a iliopectineal line intact. So if there is a fracture, it should be only posterior side. That is, towards my left side, it should either be posterior wall, posterior column, or posterior column with posterior wall fracture. So one of these three. So whenever, I'm repeating, whenever iliopectineal line is intact and we suspect a fracture on that hip, acetabular fracture, so iliopectineal line represents anterior column. That anterior column is not involved. Means you have left with only posterior, isolated posterior wall, isolated posterior column, or posterior wall with posterior column is what can be suspected. So let us see. If you see the picture here, so iliopectineal line is intact. You can exclude anterior column, anterior wall, transverse with posterior wall, and these complex varieties, which I told you, T-shaped anterior column with posterior hemitransverse and both columns. I want to wall, posterior column with posterior wall. These are the possibilities. And if you have ilioischial line intact, that means you have got posterior column also intact. You left only with posterior wall. So the diagnosis will be posterior wall fracture alone. But if you have ilioischial line which is broken, then it becomes posterior column fracture or posterior column with posterior wall. Let us see how it goes. So if we see onto this side, whenever iliopectineal line is broken, that is minus means when it is disrupted, what it represents is anterior column is involved. What are the conditions which involve anterior column? Either iliopectineal line which is disrupted, anterior wall, anterior column, or transverse fracture, transverse with posterior wall, or one of these complex varieties which are known as T-shaped anterior column, posterior hemitransverse, and both column. So whenever there is iliopectineal line which is disrupted, these are the possibilities which arise. The next line which we have to see is ilioischial line. If ilioischial line another important thing is the left side can be completely ignored because it can't be isolated posterior wall, isolated posterior column, or both. Can be posterior isolated things can be excluded because it should either be a complex variety which involves the both the columns or a anterior column or anterior wall alone. So if your ilioischial line which is intact, it means you have only anterior wall or anterior column possibility. And if your inferior pubic ramus, which is broken, or the obturator ring, which is broken, it makes it anterior column fracture. That is anterior column. But if your obturator ring is intact and iliopectineal line is gone, then it becomes anterior wall fracture alone. So similarly, when ilioischial component is also, ilioischial line is also broken, then it makes it a transverse fracture, transverse with posterior wall, or one of these complex varieties, wherein you can just choose to go ahead and see the obturator ring involvement and diagnose whether it is a transverse or a T-shaped fracture. I'll show you how it is by interacting with Dr. Atul. So let us just take this example. Atul, this is the fracture. The patient has a fracture on right side. What would you like to draw in this?
First, I would like to see iliopectineal line.
Okay.
Always, in any case.
Right.
So here, iliopectineal line appears okay. Intact.
Right. Right. I am just, for representation sake, I've drawn on left side also. But if you see here, yeah. That is iliopectineal line, which is intact. Wonderful.
Okay.
So that means, if at all, if there is an injury, that should be on the posterior side alone. So you can exclude all this anterior column, transverse, and transverse with posterior wall, and complex varieties of these three fractures. So you left with only these three possibilities, right?
Yeah.
So what do you want to draw next?
So now I want to draw ilioischial line. So ilioischial line, I will like to see Jure views, but still here near the inferior pubic ramus, there may be a fracture, but most of the times it appears intact.
Right. Okay. So that means it is intact. Yes. Then what is your next
step? It's not a posterior column also.
Right. Okay.
So you can exclude with the wall.
Right. Okay. Great. So that means you can exclude posterior column with posterior wall also.
Yes.
Because whatever that involves posterior column is not there. So it should be isolated posterior wall. Wonderful. So we are at the diagnosis.
Yes.
So it boils down to posterior wall fracture alone. Let me just show you CT scan picture in this. So that is a posterior wall fracture. Your column is intact.
Yes.
Wonderful. Thank you. So that's been fixed with. So once you know the diagnosis, then you know how to approach either posterior take to another. So what is the line which you want to draw now?
So again, see, always pectineal line. Iliopectineal line first.
Right.
So here, iliopectineal line is intact, so it excludes all anterior, pure anterior, and all complex.
Great. So whenever there is iliopectineal involvement, there should be isolated posterior component fracture. Let it be a posterior wall or posterior column with posterior wall, right?
Yes.
Okay. So next, I have drawn ilioischial line. That is also intact. Okay. What does it say?
So it's a posterior wall fracture.
Okay. So it's another posterior wall fracture in here. So I've kept simple fractures first so that it is easy to understand. So it's a very big chunk in here where you've got posterior wall fracture alone.
Yes.
The column is intact if you can see.
Yes.
So that's being fixed with two screws, interfragmentary and then plate. So let me just take you through next possibility.
Yes.
So towards right hip.
Yes.
Let me start. It is
iliopectineal line first.
Yeah.
So that is broken.
Yeah.
So that excludes pure posterior.
Right. Well, isolated posterior things can be excluded.
So it may be pure anterior or all complex.
Yeah. Great. Wonderful. So the next line?
Ilioischial line, which is also broken.
Yeah, ilioischial line is also broken. And now the interesting thing comes.
Obturator.
We can exclude anterior wall isolated, anterior column isolated. Right. So obturator ring seems to be intact in here. Yeah.
So whatever view is, it's intact.
Yeah. So what does it say?
So if it is intact, that means the T anterior column, posterior hemitransverse and back column is excluded.
Right. So only in, if you see this particular picture, only last three varieties you have got obturator ring which is broken.
Yes.
So here obturator ring is not broken, so we can exclude all those last three, the complex varieties. So you are left with only two possibilities. So transverse and transverse with posterior wall.
So whatever,
if you draw picture, a line here.
Here the posterior wall is intact.
Yeah.
So this becomes pure transverse.
Yeah, it's a transverse fracture actually. There was a minimally displaced posterior wall. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, but X-ray, we didn't have the oblique views in that.
Yeah.
So this makes a transverse fracture where you have got obturator ring, which is completely intact. Although both columns are involved, it can't be called as both column fracture because a part of the acetabulum is in continuation with the sciatic buttress. So this has been, since we know the diagnosis, we went through anterior and later posterior and fixed both the things. He also had associated pelvic injury. That's been also, yeah. So the next thing is relatively complex.
Yes. So first is iliopectineal line is broken.
Right.
So posterior is out.
Yeah, wonderful. So we can exclude posterior, isolated posterior wall, isolated posterior column, or posterior column with posterior wall can be excluded whenever there is broken iliopectineal line. That means there should be anything which is happening on the anterior side or combined anterior posterior injury. Yeah.
Then I like to have an ilioischial line, which is also appears to be broken.
Okay. Yeah, it's also gone. So
it is not pure anterior also.
Right. We can exclude these two also. Anterior
pure anterior and pure posterior are excluded.
Right.
So remaining, now I would like to see obturator ring, which is also broken here.
Right. Inferior. So that makes you exclude something?
Transverse and transverse with posterior wall.
Right. These two things can also be excluded because
obturator ring
is also gone. So only left with these three possibilities.
Yeah.
Which are known as complex varieties. T and
yes. So do you have any other views?
So do you want to get any other views?
Yes, both.
Yeah, I've got
Jude views.
Okay. So that is a view.
That shows spur sign.
Yeah. So this particular sign makes it, you can directly say that bicolumnar. Both column. Yeah.
Because the iliac wing and the axial skeleton is dissociated from acetabulum.
Right. So this acetabulum part is going to be displaced medially or internally. And you see the spur sign of the iliac wing. Wonderful.
Spur sign specifically seen on obturator view?
Yeah.
Yes.
So that
is an important point.
Yes, whenever you have a complex variety, this particular view can give a clue to diagnose both column fracture or bicolumnar fracture.
Yes.
So obturator oblique view.
Yes.
Wonderful. So let us move on with few more examples to make it easy to understand for people.
Iliopectineal line is intact.
Right.
So it is pure posterior thing.
Yeah. So we can exclude
all anterior and all complex.
Yeah. So it should be either isolated posterior wall, posterior column, or both. Posterior column with posterior wall.
So now ilioischial line is also broken.
Right.
So posterior column involvement is definitely present.
Right. So either it should be posterior column or posterior column with posterior wall.
So for wall, I like to see, yes, there is a wall fragment seen there. So it is a posterior wall with column.
Wonderful. So it's posterior column with posterior wall. So if you see here, very small chunk of posterior wall is also there along with the posterior column fracture. So that will guide us to take what approach and how to proceed about this. So unless somebody knows about classification, it's very difficult to venture any kind of surgery in these complex varieties of fractures.
Yes.
So another simple thing to diagnose.
So iliopectineal line is broken.
Right. That means?
It's not pure posterior, no posterior.
So no posterior. So those things are excluded. Yes.
So ilioischial line appears to be broken in the obturator ring. So maybe intact.
Ilioischial line is intact.
Intact. So it becomes pure anterior.
Yeah. Anything which is anterior, it's not combined. So it should. So we can exclude these complex varieties.
Yes.
So no transverse with posterior wall, no complex varieties, TR, yes. ACPT, R and B, both column. So we left with only anterior wall or anterior. Yeah. So anything else you want to see now?
Now I want to see obturator view and iliac view.
Yeah. But if you, with this picture, I think you can assess there is an injury to obturator ring. Inferior pubic ramus is involved, right?
Yes. So both views and CT scan.
Right. So that makes it an anterior column fracture. Right. I'll show you the CT. So that is the picture of this particular patient. So it's anterior column fracture. This is the anterior column, which you can see. And in these things, obviously, although there is central dislocation of the head, so you know where to approach.
Yes.
So what approach you have to take first so that you get the reduction. So this was fixed through a Stopas approach. And another example, both
iliopectineal line is broken, ilioischial line is broken.
Yeah, iliopectineal is broken. That means
it appears to be double shadow of obturator ring.
Yeah, wonderful. So let us go step by step. Iliopectineal line is broken means?
Means there is no pure posterior fractures.
Right. So posterior wall, posterior column, and posterior column with posterior wall can be excluded, right?
Yeah.
Next is ilioischial line.
Ilioischial line is broken. So no anterior column or anterior wall.
Can be excluded, right? Yes. So now we left with only transverse with posterior wall or complex varieties, that is T-shaped anterior column, posterior mid-transverse, and bicolumn. So how to differentiate between these two? So if you see here, can you make anything which is disrupting?
There is an inferior pubic ramus appears to be fractured there, or there is a double shadow. So maybe obturator view will be more useful here.
Useful here, but I don't have, so with this you can make the inferior pubic ramus which is fractured. That means you can exclude transverse variety of fracture, right? So you left with only where obturator ring is involved, usually T-shaped anterior column with posterior hemitransverse and bicolumnar fractures. So it should be either of these, which can be easily diagnosed with a CT scan. And can be planned accordingly.
Yeah.
So here in this case, it was a T-shaped fracture. So the posterior column is significantly displaced. That takes you posterior first, so that you get the reduction and come back anteriorly if needed, or do something from posterior side only on the anterior side by percutaneous fixation or something like that. So that you get the reduction, anatomical reduction. I'll show you. So this is the posterior column with very minimally displaced anterior column. So which was fixed with posterior first, followed by anterior column fixation through Stopas approach.
Yes.
So another example. So iliopectineal is gone.
Yes.
That means posterior isolated posterior things can be excluded. Either posterior column, posterior wall, or posterior wall with posterior column can be excluded.
Yes.
So next to see is ilioischial line.
That is also broken.
That is also broken. So that makes it
So no anterior column, no posterior anterior wall.
Yeah. So no anterior column, no anterior wall. You left with you have to see for the obturator ring. If obturator ring is intact, that makes it
transverse.
Yeah. So transverse here in this case, wall. You have got obturator ring which is intact. So it's a transverse fracture. Although the configuration is relatively different, but it's a transverse. So he also had the Gulsen positive in
chondral
his case.
Impaction. Yes.
Yeah, chondral impaction. If you can see, so there is a Gulsen which is positive, articular impaction which has happened. That has to be elevated in these cases to get the reduction. Yeah. Thank you. This is from my side.
Okay.
So yeah, over to you. Shall I stop sharing this?
Sharing screen, yes. So now what I will do is I will run through my set of radiology and classification. And again, we will have a interactive session with Dr. Srinivas. So this is very important. That is why we are taking two lectures of the same topic, so that you will be there will be no doubt in your mind that which type of fracture it is, because it is extremely important from where you have to approach this fracture. So this is the first big step. If you don't do that, you will fall into problem. So classification is Judet and Luternil, basic and complex. The basic, you know the types: posterior wall, posterior column, anterior column, and transverse. So this is posterior wall. This is a posterior column, the entire length. Then comes the anterior wall. Then comes the anterior column, and then the transverse. So this is the transverse fracture, which comes as a basic type. Then comes the complex, that is posterior column, posterior wall. Is we see that is we have seen both. Transverse with posterior wall. So this is a transverse fracture. Then this is with the posterior wall. T-shaped fracture, when there is a transverse element and then you have a obturator ring involvement. And anterior wall or anterior column with posterior hemitransverse, and both columns can be seen nicely on CT scan. But if both column on obturator ring, obturator view, if you see spur sign, that clearly says that this is a bicolumnar fracture. So any X-ray, you will come to see teardrop, dome, posterior wall, iliopectineal line, ilioischial line, and anterior wall. So what is iliopectineal line? So this is iliopectineal line. If it is broken, that indicates that this is a anterior column fracture. Then there is an anterior rim, which is in line with anterior pubic ramus. If it is broken, that means there is an anterior wall fracture. Then there is an ilioischial line. If it is broken, then it is a posterior column. Then posterior rim is in line with inferior pubic ramus. If it is broken, then it is posterior wall. And in the end, it is a posterior teardrop. That teardrop has to be seen whether it is displaced centrally in cases of medial displacement of the fractured hip and acetabular fractures. And in the end, we have to see the dome, we have to see the gulls, we have to see for the cartilage impaction. So the obturator oblique view will show you a complete obturator foramen, the complete anterior column by iliopectineal line, and a line along with the inferior pubic ramus ischial tuberosity, that is a posterior wall. So obturator oblique is for anterior column and the posterior wall. Then comes the iliac oblique, which is for ilioischial line. It is for posterior column, and it's in the line with the anterior wall, which is in the superior pubic ramus. That indicates anterior wall fracture. So, friends, we have seen that all the lines. So, we'll come to the algorithm again. We have to see first iliopectineal line. If iliopectineal line is intact, as Dr. Srinivas said, then it is posterior wall, posterior column, or posterior association with column with wall. If ilioischial line is intact, it is pure posterior wall. If it is broken, then it is posterior column with posterior wall or pure posterior column. If iliopectineal line is broken, then it is pure anterior, that is anterior wall, anterior column, or transverse variety, or complex like T, anterior column, hemitransverse, or bicolumn. Then you have to see again ilioischial line. If it is intact, then it becomes complete anterior, that is anterior wall, anterior column. Whether it has a pubic extension, then it becomes anterior column. If there is no pubic extension, then it is anterior wall. And if along with iliopectineal line, ilioischial line is broken, then it is transverse, transverse with posterior wall, T, hemitransverse, or bicolumn. Then next thing you have to see is obturator ring. If obturator ring is intact, then it is transverse. And if there is a wall, then it is transverse with posterior wall. If obturator ring is broken, then it is, you have to see for spur sign on obturator view. If it is present, then it is a bicolumn. If it is absent, to differentiate between both, you do CT scan and decide whether it is T or hemitransverse or anterior column with posterior hemitransverse. So come, let's see the few examples. Srinivas, this is the example. So what you will like to see first?
Yeah. So iliopectineal line, which I want to draw first.
Yes. So iliopectineal line is?
It represents anterior column.
It is intact.
If here it is intact.
Yes.
So that makes it think only about posterior side. Either it should be a posterior wall or posterior column, or posterior column with posterior wall.
Yeah. So here iliopectineal line is intact. Ilioischial line is also intact.
Yeah. So you have got only with left with posterior wall alone. It should be a posterior wall fracture.
So this is a simple example of posterior wall fracture. So you decide that to go from the posterior side. This is another example. This is a CT scan for you. So what you see here?
Yeah, iliopectineal line seems to be intact. Ilioischial line, since it's not an X-ray, seems to be broken here to me.
Yes, you can see here.
Yeah. So that makes it, so iliopectineal line intact means anything on posterior side.
Yes. And here is the walls also seen.
Yeah. So, since ilioischial line is also broken, it makes it posterior column with posterior wall.
So, right. So, again, this protocol. And here, iliopectineal line is intact. Ilioischial line is broken and wall is there. So, it is posterior column with posterior wall. So,
here in this example. Yeah. I can see iliopectineal line, which is gone here.
Yes.
Ilio, that makes it, and ilioischial line is also gone.
Yes. Right? So both lines are broken here. And?
Yeah. And you got integrity of the obturator ring is maintained.
And you can see some posterior comminution.
Comminution is also there. Agreed.
So?
So that makes it, see, since the next thing which we have to see is, you have to see for the integrity of the obturator ring or inferior pubic ramus, which is intact. That makes it transverse fracture.
So and with here posterior you can see the obturator ring is intact.
Yeah. Yes. Wonderful. So it makes it, it becomes transverse fracture with posterior wall.
Posterior wall fracture. Correct. So here again, iliopectineal line is broken. So posterior involvement is gone. Again, ilioischial line is broken. So pure anterior is gone. So an obturator ring is intact. You can see in the obturator view. So this becomes transverse with posterior wall. Another example.
Yeah. So iliopectineal line is gone.
That means pure posterior
can be excluded. Yeah. So the next possibility is we have to see ilioischial line. Ilioischial line is also gone.
Yes.
So that makes it. So you have to anterior wall, anterior column, isolated can be excluded. Should be one of the complex varieties. Transverse with posterior wall, or one of these complex T-shaped anterior column, posterior hemitransverse, or both columns. So if you see
obturator
yes, obturator ring is intact. That makes it a transverse fracture.
So transverse, and there is
a combination on the posterior side.
Yes. So
transverse with posterior wall.
Yes. So another example. So these are the Jude views.
Okay.
So this is iliopectineal.
Iliopectineal line is gone.
Yes.
Iliopectineal line is gone means you can exclude isolated posterior wall. Isolated posterior column.
Yes.
Posterior column with posterior wall can also be excluded.
Yes. And next is iliopectineal line.
Ilioischial line is also gone.
Yes.
So you can exclude pure anterior column, anterior wall. Pure anterior column, pure anterior wall. So then it can either be a transverse fracture or T-shaped or anterior column, posterior hemitransverse, or both columns. So one of these complex varieties can also be there. So next thing to see is obturator foramen.
Yes.
So that is also broken.
So
that next thing to see is spursine in an oblique view. Obturator oblique view. Here it is positive.
Yes.
So that makes it bicolumnar fracture.
So this is a bicolumn fracture. So similar revision again. So here you can see iliopectineal line broken. So pure posterior is ruled out. Then there is a pure ilioischial line which is broken. So pure anterior fractures are ruled out. That is anterior wall, anterior column. Then you see obturator ring which is also broken. That means transverse variety of fractures are ruled out. Then on obturator view, you see the spursine, which is seen here, which completely says that this is a bicolumnar fracture. Yeah. So again, another example, Srinivas.
Yeah, iliopectineal line seems to be broken to me.
Yes.
That means isolated posterior wall, posterior column, and posterior column with posterior wall can be excluded.
Yes.
Ilioischial line also seems to be broken. That means isolated anterior wall, anterior column can be excluded.
Yes.
So you left with.
Yeah.
Complex.
Yes.
So in this integrity of obturator foramen, that is also disrupted, it seems.
Yeah, that is also
so that broken. That makes it broken. So you can exclude transverse.
Yes.
Transverse with posterior wall also. Left with possibilities of T-shaped or bicolumnar or anterior column with posterior hemitransverse.
So here, there appears to be spur sign, but to be on safe side, we can see this on CT scan.
Yeah, yes.
So
it seems bicolumnar fracture to me.
Yes, because the axial part is separate and some part of acetabulum is free floating here, forming the spur sign.
Right.
So few cases of bicolumnar fractures still have a posterior wall element. So there is a variant of bicolumn fracture with the posterior wall fractures. So same, iliopectineal line broken, posterior ruled out, ilioischial line broken, transverse or transverse with posterior wall, T hemitransverse bicolumn. Then comes obturator ring broken, then T or anterior column hemitransverse, then comes posterior wall and free ilium, that spur sign is present, then it is a bicolumn fracture. So last example, on the left side, you have to see.
Yeah.
So
there is iliopectineal line, which seems to be not clear. It seems to be broken here.
Yes. So appears to be broken.
Yeah. Because there is a tilt.
There is a tilt.
Ilioischial line is intact.
in time. So iliopectineal line may be broken. So we assume that. And iliopectineal line is broken, not broken. So ilioischial line is not broken means it's not pure posterior. And so there can be anterior fractures or complex fractures or transverse fractures. So we'll see. So iliopectineal line broken, ilioischial line is intact.
It should either be anterior wall, anterior column, isolated.
So this only is possible. CT scan.
That's a anterior wall fracture.
So this is protocol which you have to be very properly. If you follow, then you can classify each and every fracture just on X-rays. If you have AP and Jude views, in some cases you need CT scan, but by the end of radiology, you can classify all your fractures. So four things are very important. One is iliopectineal line, one is ilioischial line, then obturator ring, and then spur sign. So if you know all these four things, you can classify all 10 types of acetabular fractures. So if you know which fracture is there, by the end of your investigations, you can decide on your approach, whether you will need only Coker-Langenbach, ilioinguinal, or combined approach. So you can find out the approach depending on the classification. Thank you.
So that's wonderful. I agree with all the points. With with this system, I think it can be used by anybody, and only by taking an X-ray, of course, with oblique views also, we can diagnose all acetabular fractures, all varieties of acetabular fractures.
Yes. So, Dr. Ashok?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, now the first part of our basic pelvioacetabular trauma is classification of acetabular fractures, and radiology is over.
Thank you very much, sir. And I'm sure a lot of students have been benefited by it. We have streamed it both on YouTube as well as Facebook and Ortho TV website. And if there are any questions, I'll collect them and ask you in the next episode, which is on the next Monday at 4 p.m. So thank you very much, sir, again. And Yes, sir. Go ahead, sir.
Everybody has access to this particular thing, then it will be easy for everyone to classify the fracture.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much, sir.